send in a video of yourself perched up on a hill, flapping your arms and going, ack, 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 because Harold the H, ack, 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 Peacock, our historian, has got another great story, and people love this segment, Ipswich history. And this is about the last lady to be sentenced to death in Ipswich. Come in there, ark, 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 man.
Yeah, good morning, Danny G. You woke me up with those multiple arc, arc, arc.
Well, let's get on Facebook. Go into historyoutthere.com or westbremerradio.com.au with you perched up on a hill. Maybe put some feathers on or just pretend to be a bird and go, arc, 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 and send it through to those Facebook posts, please.
Yeah, that would be very awesome. And anywhere from around the world, too. Doesn't matter where.
Now, this lady here. This, by the way, Jeff Harrison's listening. He said that our premier has taken us back to 1939 because I made a comment about, you know, you can't go into restaurants unless you're double vaxxed and stuff now. And he's come back and he said, well, it's your Labor premier doing this. And I sent back to him, you'll love this, Harold. I said, well, if you don't behave yourself, we're going to paint Tory on your car and on your shirts. You know, get it, Tory? Because, in, you know, back in 39 they put on, you know. Yeah, good on you.
No,
well on you, Harold.
No,
you're right across the, you're a typical peacock. Now, who is this lady, this woman who was hung?
Yeah, it was in 1905. Her name was Amelia Clare Linke. Mm. And she was arrested on a charge of willful murder of her one-year-old son at Stan's paddock between Verner's Siding and Fernvale.
Wow.
Now, Amelia, she was the daughter of a well-to-do selector in the Lower District. Mm. She was just 20 years old when her son was born. He was named Lenny Hyde Linke and was the illegitimate son of an Ipswich commercial traveller.
Wow.
Now, after her son Lenny was born in 1904, Amelia was working as a domestic servant for the former mayor of Ipswich, Thomas Baines.
Whoa.
And now, Amelia boarded Lenny with a single woman in North Ipswich and paid her 7 shillings a week to look after him.
Mm.
On the morning of Tuesday, the 12th of September 1905, the woman brought Lenny to the Ipswich train station. That's because Amelia had said she wanted to take him to board somewhere else.
Mm.
The three of them went and had Lenny's photograph taken and then returned to the station.
Mm.
Now, before handing Lenny over, the woman asked Amelia who the father was.
Mm.
Amelia said it was Lenny Hyde Symes.
Mm.
Now, Symes was the son of a well-known publicist, journalist and elocutionist, and had married another woman just months before young Lenny was born. In fact, Symes's wife had only recently given birth to their first son.
This is a tangled web.
That's right. Now, Amelia and young Lenny boarded the train to Esk.
Right.
Now, Amelia got off the train at Verner's Siding, went through the fence into Span's paddock, and after walking for some time, she tragically smothered the baby and put it in a hollow ironbark log.
Oh,
now, she stayed all night sitting by the log in the paddock.
Mm.
At sunrise, she walked back to Verner's Siding in Fernvale and took the train back to Ipswich. A month later, the owner of the paddock was looking for a horse, and a boy with him instead found baby's clothes, the same that were in the photograph, and pieces of skull and bones. Now, Amelia was committed to stand trial at the Supreme Court in Brisbane, but it was relocated to the Circuit Court here in Ipswich instead.
Mm.
Now, Amelia was found guilty of willful murder, and I'll read the judge's sentencing because it's quite chilling, Danny.
Right.
The sentence is that you be taken hence to the custody from whence you came, and at such time and such place as the governor and council shall direct, you be hanged by the neck till you are dead.
Ooh.
May the Lord have mercy on your soul.
Amen.
So, Danny, Amelia was sentenced to death here in the Ipswich Court. There was, however, some public sympathy for Amelia. You see, Amelia's mother was considered by the family, in the words of the day, as a bit queer. Amelia's younger brother was said to be of weak intellect. Her father was also considered very queer. He believed in witches, wore a whip around his neck to keep the spirits away. He accused Amelia of putting lice in his bed, and told his children never to visit him or he'd burn the house down.
Where does he get this from? You're unbelievable.
Oh.
You're searching under beds that aren't even there anymore.
Yeah, but then there was more evidence because there was Amelia's older brother. There was the former Ipswich mayor.
Oh.
There was a head teacher of the Lowood State School.
Oh.
And the controversial Dr. William von Losberg. They all testified that Amelia was a girl of very low intellect.
Oh.
So the deputy governor acting on and for behalf of the governor, he was left with very little choice. He commuted Amelia's death sentence to 3 years imprisonment with hard labour.
Wow.
Amelia lived a long life and passed away in 1959 in Townsville, aged 75.
Yeah.
But never again was a woman ever sentenced to death here in Ipswich.
But she was sentenced to death but didn't cop the death penalty.
That's right. Yes, it was like, it was committed to 3 years hard labour. So even that wasn't much. So the death penalty for the crime, given the circumstances, it was considered way too much. But it happened right here in the Ipswich courthouse.
And she lived right through till 1959.
That's right.
She lived with that for the rest of her life. How sad is that? What a great... I'm not making this up. Best researcher, historyoutthere.com. This bloke is putting a book together. We're going to go and support it. Come on, Ipswich Mayor. Come on, Teresa. You know, got to be behind this bloke. He's writing really great stuff. The interesting stories about this wonderful city of Ipswich. Good on you, Ranger. Good on... Oh, for God's sake, I'm losing it. Harold H. Ah, 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 Peacock. And don't forget, get on, record yourself doing the... flapping your arms and sending through to westbremerradio.com.au or historyoutthere.com. Good on you, Harold.